Floor plans are the best way to read and understand architecture. And in this video, we're going to see how to create three different styles of floor plans with the same project. Now, this video is sponsored by Rayon, a web-based design software that can help you draw floor plans in a way that's faster than CAD, but simpler than BIM. But of course, I'll tell you more about them later. Now, let's start with our first style. So if you're presenting this to a client working in real estate or simply just like rendered floor plans, this one is for you. For this one, you'll need a 3D model of your project and a render engine. In my case, I'm using SketchUp and D5 Render, but you can do this with any software that you like. So this is a 3D model of the apartment. It's a basic 3D model done in SketchUp, but you can use the program you feel the most comfortable with. And also make sure the floor material is different from the wall material, section material, etc. This is so we can apply easily our materials after in our rendering program in D5 Render. Now let's try to import or draw the furniture that maybe you will not find in your libraries that you have in D5 Render. Like for example, doors, cabinets, windows, very specific elements that adapt to your architecture. You can use your own personal library or a library like the 3D warehouse in my case. Here you can see some elements that are already in the model. Now I'll start D5 Render and use the Live Sync plugin to synchronize with the model. As soon as I have D5 Render open, I'll save two different types of scenes. For the first one, I'll go to the view settings, select top, and save the scene. This will be the orthographic projection. And for the second one, I'll stay in perspective mode, leave my field of view in 40, and adjust the perspective to the frame. This way you can choose from two different types of floor plan views and the one that suits your needs the most. Also in SketchUp, I added a rectangular plane beneath my model just so I could see the shadows and control the color of the whole canvas of the background. Now I'll also go to my environment tab in D5 Render and I'll add some interesting lights. Here I'm going to add a soft HDRI and also add a custom sun where the intensity I'm going to leave it at 1 and the disk radius at 10. This will make sure I have some soft shadows on my floor plan. So this way I'll have some shadows that give a volumetric feeling to the image. And here you want to make sure you don't have extremely dark shadows or shadows that have a low sun and make everything look dark, or extremely soft shadows that also don't give any depth to the image. Now I'll start applying materials. First for the floor, I'll apply a herringbone wood flooring. I'll just go to my assets, go to materials and search for herringbone. Now for the section cut, I want to make sure it's in a dark color so you can understand the cut in the section of the floor plan. I'll also apply some tiling to the bathroom and the kitchen. Also a separate material to the balcony, to the entrance, and of course to the windows and window frames. Here you want to add as much material as possible, as much material as you think it's possible or you need for your rendering floor plan. Then I'll start adding assets that of course will give life to a floor plan. I'll start from the general ones, like for example, adding a bed, adding a sofa, a fridge, also adding furniture like rugs, tables, food, plants, and finally more clutter like shoes, people, pieces of art, etc. This will give a lot of life to your image. Now let's go back to our image settings and increase the brightness and exposure of our image and update our scene. As soon as you've added all of your assets, you'll go to the image settings and render it. That's it. This is our first render, and as you can see, it has a lot of colors and a lot of information, and it's useful for understanding materials, spaces, and overall distribution. Now let's go to our second style. For our second style, I'll go to my SketchUp model, create a section, and export the section as a DWG file. Here, our goal is to convert this not so pretty section into a clean and crisp floor plan. Now, I don't want to complicate myself by passing this onto Revit or AutoCAD, so I'll use Rayon, which is the sponsor of today's video. Rayon is my preferred method of perfecting and pimping out my plan. You can use your program of choice, like for example any BIM software or CAD software, but I personally like Rayon for its low pricing plans, and also it has a free option if you want to try it out. Also, I can use Rayon on any computer. I don't have to worry about computer specs because Rayon is a web-based design software. Now I'm going to open Rayon. I'm going to go to new file. Now I'm going to go to import file, and Rayon will help me scale out the plan. Here I can verify that the scale is correct. Now, since this is such a simple plan, I'll quickly draw the walls with the wall tool, or you can just press W on your keyboard. Now I can turn on and off my import layers to see where are all the elements I want to place. And next, I'll place the windows and doors. With Rayon, Just click on OP on your keyboard for opening, or look for the opening button. And you can choose either a door or a window, or you can also browse the block library and choose from there. So I'll select this one for my doors, and I'm gonna start placing them all over my plan. So as you can see, it's very easy to use. I can go back and forth and change the door if I want, or adjust the opening size. Now I'll select my windows and place them on my plan. I'll use the zone tool to identify the different zones in my apartment. I just click on the area and that's it. Now, since here I want to differentiate between two different zones, I can use the zone divider and split the zone in two. Here you can change the name of each zone and adjust the style of the hatch. So let's do that. Now for my living room and bedrooms, I'll also add a herringbone hatch. I can adjust the scale, color, and intensity of the hatch. Next, I'll start adding some furniture into my floor plan. Now, this is probably one of the best parts about using Rayon, is that the block library is huge. It has more than 2,000 blocks, as you guys can see here. They're always updating it, and you can just simply browse it or type in what you want, select it, and import it. Honestly, it's really easy. I'll add the basic furniture like beds, kitchen, the living room, and of course, the accessories. And then add more furniture like plants, add people, food, etc. The idea here is also to give some life to our image. Now for a crisp plan, I'll also add some dimensions. Now, and this is really easy with the dimension tool. Finally, I'll adjust the general style of everything. So I'll select my walls from the layer tab and increase the stroke width just so it stands out a little bit more than the rest. In Rayon, you can change styles really easily. It's basically like any Adobe software, but with the advantages of a CAD program. Next, I'll adjust the intensity of my floor plan. And as soon as it's finished, I can export it as a DWG file or share it with my team and they can also use it. This is the floor plan that I started with, and this is the one I have now. Now, the best thing about Rayon is that it's so easy to use. It's faster than the CAD software, but of course, simpler than a BIM software. If you want to use Rayon for free, there will be a link in the description to sign up completely for free. And I want to thank Rayon for sponsoring this part of the video. Now, let's go into our third and final style. I'll import my Rayon floor plan onto Photoshop. I'll import four different files. The first one will be the furniture file, then the dimensions file, the walls and doors file, and also the pattern file. I'll drag them in one by one and make sure they coincide in scale and position. Then I will group all of them in one folder. Now I'm going to create a background layer and add a new color. This is the color code that I used for my background. Now I'm going to stand on my pattern layer, and only with a marquee tool, or you can press M on your keyboard, I'm going to select the areas that have the floor pattern. Now with a mask tool, I'm going to exclude the rest and place the opacity of this layer at 20%. Now I'm going to create a new layer, create a marquee selection of the floor slab, and color it with this milky white. That way my apartment can stand out much more. Next, I want to stand on my walls layer, select outside, and invert the selection by pressing Ctrl+Shift+I. After this, I'm going to create a new layer and fill it with red, this specific red. Now I'm going to erase from the selection the windows and the doors. Also, you want to make sure the wall layer is on top of all of the other layers. Now, I'm going to create a new layer, and with the marquee tool, create a series of rectangles in the places where there would be shadows. So to add the selection, I'm going to hold the shift key and I can add as many rectangles as I want. Now, if I want to remove them from the selection, I can use the alt key. So as soon as I have this selection that you guys see right here, I'm going to color it all black. Now I'm going to lower the opacity of this layer at around 10%. These are very subtle shadows that we want. Now you can leave it like this if you want, but we can go an extra step and add a sketchy feeling to our drawing, a sketchy texture to our drawing. So I'm going to do this by using some sketchy brushes in Photoshop. I created my own sketchy brushes, and as a matter of fact, you can actually download them from the link. There's a free version and there's a paid version. You can download the ones that suits you the best. And as soon as you install them, they should look something like this. So I'm going to select this brush specifically, select a black color, and control click on top of my shadows layer, on the thumbnail of my shadows layer. Here, I'll only paint the area of the shadows, and as soon as I'm done, I'll lower the opacity to about here. Next, with this same selection of the shadows, I'm going to press Control Shift I or invert the selection. I'm going to create a new layer and call it Sketchy Texture. I'll select the brush, but this time I'm going to modify the shape dynamic so that every time I paint with the brush, Photoshop flips the texture in both directions. Here, I'll just paint in all of the canvas and again lower the opacity. Now I'm going to create a selection of my furniture. Just click outside of the furniture layer with a magic wand and I'll have all of my furniture selected. Here I want to erase the rug from my selection, so I'll just hit the Alt key and with the wand tool I'll just click on top of the rug. And you want to make sure here the contiguous option is selected. Now with the selection, I'm going to create a new layer, fill it with white, lower the fill to 0%, and now we're going to go to our blending options and we're going to add a drop shadow. I'm going to lower the opacity of the drop shadow and adjust the angle so it coincides with the other shadows that we have created. This will add some cool shadows and depth to my furniture. Now to emphasize the wall shadows, I'm going to go back to my shadows layer and control click on top of the layer. I'll create a new layer and start painting in some small shadows closer to the wall and in a higher opacity. This will give more importance to the walls and the architecture. And finally, let's press Ctrl+Shift+Alt+E and merge all of the layers together. Then let's go to Camera Raw Filter and add some texture, add some clarity, and let's go to the Color Mixer and increase the saturation only of the red layer. And this is my final result. If I was going to present this project to a client, I would probably present the rendered floor plan, this one right here. But if I was still in a design correction stage, I would probably present the clean floor plan. But if I wanted to include this in my portfolio or just post this on social media so my colleagues and peers can see this, I would probably present the conceptual floor plan. I think all of these floor plans are great ideas, great style ideas that you can use in different scenarios. Which one do you like the most and which one do you think you're going to use the most? Thank you all for watching this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.